Howdy folks, how are y'all doing? Kep here, and welcome back to another episode of our Tekkit Classic Reborn Adventure Let's Play series of awesomeness. Thank you so much for returning and being good patrons to the series. You guys always come back, you love it a lot, you always leave lots of likes and comments, and I'm very appreciative of it. Today is a very special episode, as it is episode 10, and a lot of stuff we have to talk about. So first off, let me address a couple of issues. Issue number one, in the last video, I attempted to make a windmill, and I failed. And I actually called out the mod maker, the maker of the mod pack, as a liar. And I'm very sorry for that. I didn't mean to imply that he was a liar, merely that I mistook his words to mean something they did not. What he meant was that we had windmills, didn't necessarily mean that we had the ones I was thinking of, so that was my bad. I'm sorry, Mr. Nithilus. Oh boy, I'm about to add insult to injury here. I think I might be pronouncing his name incorrectly. Oh, I built a little reed farm with a bridge. We'll get to that here in a minute. Let's head upstairs and make sure I'm saying Nithilus's name correctly. It's convenient, because his name, it's right here on the project table. Nithilus, yes. I'm sorry for basically calling you a liar on the internet. That was inappropriate of me, and that wasn't my intention. I was confused, and I'm sorry. And this apology's gone on for far too long. He has agreed to, and this is so cool. He agreed in the comments of the last video to add windmills to the pack, which is awesome. So thank you so much. He's gonna add the originals, and he's gonna change, I believe, the recipe for the other ones so that we can use the originals to upgrade to the kinetic energy windmills. It's all very confusing. I'm not familiar with the kinetic energy stuff, so we'll get to that when we get there. And actually, Nithilus, if you don't mind, and this is probably not the right place to ask this, but I was building with marble, and I noticed that marble does not have an EMC value given to it, so I had to just go keep mining it to build my walkway there. So if you could just maybe add EMC value to that while you're doing the windmill thing for me too, that would be, I would be extremely grateful. Maybe I shouldn't ask you that on YouTube though. Maybe I shouldn't make a habit of asking for things from the modpack manager in a video. Maybe I should do that in a more private place, you know, in case there's a reason, like, oh well, I can't because the Java codes collide, and you know, no one's gonna see that, no one's gonna know that. I'm gonna see it, you know, he's gonna be like, I can't do that, but then no one else is gonna get that information, and they're just gonna accuse him of stuff. Yeah, okay, well, you know what? We'll leave that request in. Could you please add EMC values to marble? And that's it. That's all I'm going to request. You've done an excellent job with this pack. I love it so much. I don't want to be needy. I don't want to come across to Nithilus as being this really needy LP'er who just demands stuff from his pack. So that'll make me happy. Just give me some EMC on the marble. I can work out the rest from there. Issue number two is apparently this series is boring for some people. Because it is too... Oh, I upgraded my client star because I ran out of space in the other one. And, yeah, so there you go. Also, emptied out just about everything that... if it didn't have an EMC value, it didn't hang around here. Or, no, I'm sorry. If it had an EMC value, it's gone now. Only things without EMC values, you know, with the exception of a couple of tools, got crushed down and shoved into the client star so that I can make more items when the situation requires it. But anyway, apparently, I've been modeling this series, this Reborn series, after my original Tekkit Classic series, and this guy whose name's on the screen right now seems to think that that's going to be boring, and that I need to spice things up, and I'm going to! I'm going to actually take his advice. I'm going to build an underwater base of operations out that way, using some pretty cool force field technology that I'm researching right now. I want to make sure I have it all down in my noggin before we start on that. And I think that probably around episode 15 or 20, we're going to get to work on that. And I'm hoping to start putting out more episodes so that episode 20 won't be 4 months away. It'll be sooner than that. But this is episode 10. I wanted to do something special, and I think I just did something special. I've announced our first goals for the series. So far, we've only been doing like little things like let's get power going, let's build a house, let's build some cool project tables and easy crafting tables. This is going to be our long-term project, though, is to build this big underground or underwater base and power it with solar and wind energy. It's going to be great, and I hope you guys will stick around. It's not going to all go down in one episode. It's going to be kind of like an overarching in the background, building stuff to make this happen. And I hope you guys will like that. If you'd like to, please comment down below, give me some feedback. And without further ado, let's actually get into the meat of this episode, because I've spent quite a bit of time now talking about things that have nothing to do with what we're doing today. And today, we are going to look at two items. That is right. We're going crazy. We're going to look at a special device for mining called the mining drill. Now, that's not as cool as the mining laser, but the mining laser also is also slightly more advanced. It requires this thing. I'm still working on this. I'm doing the research. Turning table. I mean, last time I checked, turntables are used to either you put a train on it and you rotate it around, you know, like in Thomas the Tank Engine. It's, or you put some records on there and you're, right? But apparently that's not what you do here. You need to do some latching tools and tiny pile of iron. We'll get into that in a later date. Mining drills, on the other hand, very straightforward. Iron plates. We're going to need, what, 5, 6 of these? Yeah. So let's go ahead and grab our iron. Oh, wait, we don't have any. Let's get some iron. Oh wait, we don't have any EMC. So this might add like a whole new element to the game, having to come over here and get everything out of here since I fed it all into the main system. But you know what? It is what it is. So we want to roll that. And then we're also going to need our power unit. And the power unit is going to need 3 re-batteries, some copper cable, some iron item. Okay, so we actually need to get another piece of iron. Put that in there because that's how we get our casings. So one of those will break down to 2 casings, which is how many we need here, except for we need another plate inside of there. And before I go back, do we need any more pieces of iron anyplace else? This is 10. We do need a piece of iron in the middle, though. So we'll grab 2 more. Only one of those is going to go in here, though. Okay. Excellent. And then for the rest of the power unit, it's just going to be things you've seen me build before. We've built electric circuits before. We have built re-batteries. 1, 2, okay. So I'm gonna get to work on just getting the raw materials and then we'll assemble them all together. In the meantime, though, please enjoy this sped up thing with music so that you don't spend a lot of time watching me build things that we've done before. And actually, while you're here, let me go ahead and get your feedback on that. Do you want to hear me just blabber on about random stuff while I build? Because you've all seen me build batteries before, do you really want to watch me build batteries again? Or would you rather listen to me just, you know, talk about stuff? I've gotten that backwards. Goodness gracious. Do you want to watch me build batteries and blabber on about stuff, or would you rather me fast forward with some fun music and just get to the good bits? Because I can talk for a really long time. And if you guys don't mind watching me talk for a really long time, I'll do it. I mean, I can come up with all kinds of stuff. I can talk about Stripe's gas stations. I can talk about scary video games. I can talk about my new series online here called Just a Bite, where I just recently played probably like the worst game ever. So 1, 2 pieces of 10, 2, let's just do all 10 of them. What's that gonna hurt? All 10 of them? What? Yeah, that just happened. Actually, we don't even need 10. Let's just do the 5. That'll make more sense. I played Five Nights on Freddy's on Monday's episode of Just a Bite! And it was fun. So, without further ado, fast forward music. And comment down below on what you think of the fast forward music after you finish the video or right now, like during. Like, maybe you don't know yet. Maybe you're thinking, I need an example. Give me an example, Cub. Well, here comes your example. So, just be prepared. It's coming at you now. Wow. That makes making batteries a whole lot faster when you don't have to do like all of the wow. Just wow, good grief. That was incredibly fast. So what do we have left here? We've got all of the iron plating bits, we've got the batteries, so now we just need to make an electronic circuit. I guess once we just have all the items in our inventory, we should just be able to come over here and say electronic circuit. What are we? Let's see. Oh, wait, hold on. There's 2 different ones here, but they look about the same. Boom. Well, there's our electronic circuit. Just ridiculous, isn't it? My goodness. Okay, so we need some iron and some more copper cables. Okay. No, oh, hey, look, there it is, right there, mining drill. I don't know. Oh, we can also get a chainsaw. Ooh, Now that could be fun. So we're pretty much just negating the necessity to even build the power unit or any of these items in here. By just having enough items in our inventory, I can just click and have the mining drill. Now that might not be all that great. Why is there an E here? That might not be all of that great for viewers of this series. My concern is, if you're watching this for educational purposes and I just walk over to this thing and have a whole bunch of stuff in my inventory and just click that, you might not be learning a whole lot. So if you want me to do a better job explaining the building process for each of these items, if you want to see that process versus me just walking up to the easy crafting table and grabbing one, comment down below. This is a very user-driven show, very user-driven experience. I do really want y'all's feedback on all of this stuff. So just let me know. Now we're going to put our mining drill into the bat box to charge it up. This sucker is so cool. Can't wait to start using it. And I feel like the format of this series is going to change a lot by the time this episode is over, simply because I keep asking people to give me feedback on all the different things that I do. It's probably going to start up next episode and be just completely different. So, mining drill. Some people might wonder, why do we need this? If in this series we no longer really need to go mining, we have... Oh goodness, we're next to the water and it makes noises. Oh, I found out tapping F7 will give you a window to turn down the sound effects. So there you go, folks. If that's something that you've been struggling with, now you know. You would be surprised. I do actually still do a lot of mining. Reason being, I don't have an automated system for collecting items and dumping them to collect the EMC. And I find that to be a little bit cheaty, so having something to mine with is pretty useful. And as you can see, this guy here will pretty much mine up anything you throw in its path, and it does it relatively quickly. Now, how do I explain the mining drill to people who don't know the mining drill? Let's just go through a list of its perks, right? So it's relatively quickly. It will never break. All you have to do is when it runs out of juice, you can recharge it. It can't quite break anything. It cannot break, for instance, obsidian. However, we can upgrade this little nifty tool here using these things in here, using some, or I'd probably use just 3 diamonds. And this thing, again, not sure what's going on there. This will make it, if you upgrade it to a diamond drill, it will mine faster. It will mine obsidian. And it will use slightly more energy, but there are things you can do to help with that. But there you go, mining drill. It's just, it's convenient, you know, because, I mean, it works on everything, so you don't have to, well, not everything, but it does work on gravel, as well as dirt, as well as stone, so you don't have to carry around. Look, we're no longer going to need this pickaxe or this shovel. That's 2 things out of our space that we'll never need to carry around anymore. How does it work as a weapon? Well, I don't know why I just threw myself off of there. We're gonna go attack a creeper with it, though. Come on, buddy. So, I mean, as far as weapons go, it's not the best, although it does make the creeper run away, apparently. Or maybe he was looking for... No, that creepy little creeper. He's plotting a course to get us, because he couldn't get to us from back there. He was gonna come back around here and... Oof. That makes me uncomfortable. We should get out of the caves right now. Now, an alternative to me doing, like, sped up and music and stuff is that I can just do cuts. And I can just cut to the things that I've done and be like, okay, this is how far we've made it now. And you're probably going to see a bit of those here because I'm going to build... I wasn't even going to build that this episode. We're going to build a chainsaw. Because, dadgummit, let's just build a chainsaw. You know, why not? Let's go full power tools. Episode 10, power tools. We're going... What's that? Home improvement. Yeah, let's... Okay, let's just do that. Why not? Alright, I've got all the materials, and I am back at the easy crafting table. I considered just building this inside of the project table, but I was like, you know what, we built the easy crafting table for a reason, so that we wouldn't have to do that. I've got just an assorted mess of items down here. Boom! That's what it takes to build our chainsaw. We'll take it downstairs. And I had another idea while I was in the middle of that. I was thinking to myself, you know, something else we could do in the series to be different and maybe help you guys enjoy it a bit more, is what if I went through at the start of each episode, or before each episode, before I started recording, took a look at what I needed to build an item, and I just went ahead and I built it. I had sort of the individual parts ready, not necessarily a stack of batteries, but just the tin and item casings, and you know, I had all of that ready to roll, maybe set aside in a chest. So instead of having to build that during the episode, I would just have it and it would be ready to go. How do you guys feel about that? Is that a good idea? I'm not really sure what people like. I know that when I watch YouTubers, I tend to like watching them do everything as long as they are entertaining. But I can also understand how some people might just find it boring to watch me walk around and build a lot of batteries. They might not enjoy sped up music sections or just massive chunks of the video cut out. Maybe they just want me to get in there, say, this is what you need to build it, I've got it all in a chest, let me get it all out, go over to my easy crafting table, build it, and then focus on actually using the item. Is that something you guys would prefer? Now that being said, we have a chainsaw. And dadgummit, we've got to go saw some things with our chainsaw. Where do we start? Obviously, we're going to start with a tree. Yeah, look how fast that is. Oh, and it actually drops the leaves. I didn't even know that. Oh, that's cool. Jeez, it is fast, too. Good gravy. Look at this thing. And that's another item we won't have in our hotbar. Now we won't have an axe. We'll have a chainsaw instead. So we're not saving any space necessarily on that one, but it's a chainsaw. Come on, people. We're power tooling today. Power tools! I wish I knew where some sheep were, too, because apparently we can use this as shears on a sheep. You do need to make sure you right-click and not left-click, because bad things could happen if you were attempting to shear sheep and you just bashed it over the head with this thing. Can't shear pigs. We can kill them with incredible ease with the chainsaw. Oh, my goodness. So if that's something you want to do, you want to go on a chainsaw massacre against pigs, you can do that now. Tekkit Classic, everyone. Tekkit Classic Reborn. Kill pigs with the greatest of ease. This is actually, in some small, strange way, fun. In a very strange way. I don't actually know how I feel about it. I'm a bit uncomfortable. Now, if you wanted to use your chainsaw to just, like, get rid of leaves and you don't want them to shear, if you hold down M and right-click while you have the chainsaw selected, you can go between normal and no shearing. But I kind of like shearing because it's got some EMC value in those leaves. Now, let's take a nap, and when we wake up, we're going to build yet another electronic device. Since this has become the power tool episode, we're going to go ahead and build an electric wrench. Now, the electric wrench is really great because, as you know, the standard wrench, which we have one of in here, it has a chance to destroy your machines when you use it to break them down, which it's not good. Thankfully, the electric wrench, it has two different modes now, and this is slightly different from back in the day. You can select it to a low power mode where it works exactly the same as the regular wrench, except for it doesn't take damage. This one, as you can see, takes damage. The electric wrench is obviously powered by electricity, so instead of taking damage, it just powers down eventually and you have to recharge it. Or you can put it in a lossless mode, which uses more electricity, but you don't have a chance of breaking anything. It uses a small power unit, very similar to the other power units we've been building lately. And in fact, do we might even have the things we need to build this? Let's just type in wrench here. Not quite. I didn't think we would have everything we needed. Looks like we're going to need, we have some copper cable. Probably going to need to make some more. Yeah, let's get some more tin. I'm going to get started on this thing and then we're going to take a look at it. I think that's everything we need right there. And I actually just got to thinking about something else that I wanted to present to you guys. Oh yeah, like right there. Electric wrench. Great. Did that take the atoms out of here? I didn't even see it happen. I guess it did. Another proposition I have for you. Once we Oh, Snapdragon. Did we have just... I think the game might have just crashed. No? Whoa! Weird stuff is going down right now. We've got some random bronze ingots just out of nowhere. I think we're just on the verge of a crash there. Thank goodness that did not happen. We're still in the game. We're going good. Something else I was just thinking about, though. Once we put the upgrades in here to speed this bad boy up, actually building items during the game versus having them built beforehand wouldn't take as long. But I don't know. You guys, folks, comment down below. It's all up to y'all, really. Whatever you want to see, however you want to see it done. This is episode 10. It's a milestone, and milestones, they're a good time to look back and reflect on the things that have been done before, and also to think about how we should do things differently in the future. So just comment. Leave comments. Your opinion does matter to me. I sound like a politician now. The opinion of the people matters greatly to me, and I would love your vote, thank you. So we've got lossless wrench mode enabled. Boom! Well, maybe that wasn't the best idea, because now it's in water. And the problem... What? How did I even do that? I don't... Okay, I didn't know the wrench would do that. That's pretty nuts. There we go. We got our metal former back. It's been in the water for a little while. It might be a bit on the rusty side. As you can see, lossless mode, it sucks up your power. Either that or that trap door did it. How do I put this back now? Do I just right-click it? Nope. Wow. Okay, well, that broke it. There you go. Wrenches, everyone. It's like a whole bag full of tricks. So we'll put that back down. It doesn't look like the water ruined it any. Maybe we should have waited for it to dry out before we plugged it into the power, though. And look at that. We've now gone full electric here. We've got a chainsaw, electric wrench, a mining drill. Good gravy. Oh, it didn't even use our old wrench. I guess it made a new one. And we can't seem to destroy the old one, so we're just stuck with this wrench now that we're never going to use. Let's throw that in there. Some things we're not going to use. We're not going to use the bronze. I want to keep things sort of tidy around here, so we'll just throw those items in there. And in the meantime, folks, I've given you many options, many things to consider, and I'm looking forward to reading all of your excellent feedback down in the comments. And before we go, I'm just going to do it one time, guys, please. Remember to like the video. It does actually matter a whole lot. So if you enjoyed the video, please do give it a like. And I will see you folks next time, episode 11, where we'll hopefully have a new format. Bye.